Don't let your gender ever come in the way of achieving your dreams. You are as much as an equal to a man, and you can achieve the same amount that he can do. So you don't have to let your gender come in the way at all. I started by observing wildlife, and I was very happy with the binoculars in my hand and observing birds in my backyard. And that's how the whole thing began, because I live in a place called Panvel, which is a suburban part of Navi Mumbai, and that's very green. So as a child, I've chased butterflies, I've climbed trees, and you know, seen wild boars on my street. It used to be a very tiny street, and I had fireflies in my balcony, and that's how the whole childhood years were spent. So while I began observing wildlife, I also wanted to capture those in my memory, as well as, you know, on film, on camera. So that's how the thing started. And when I was like about 11, somewhere I always have, you know, been a person who really loved watching and reading about Harry Potter and Percy Jackson. So I've been that kind of a girl. And for me, fireflies has always been a fascinating subject. And as a child, I remember seeing them in my balcony. So when I became a wildlife photographer, there's always been that dream that I wanted to capture fireflies in my camera. So last year, when the opportunity presented itself, I went along gladly. It's been a beautiful journey that started at that point. I use my photographs as a medium to tell stories of conservation. The way I see it is that photography is a powerful tool which I can use to influence people and make them fall in love with nature, and at the same time also inspire them to act and raise their voices to protect our wildlife. When it comes to wildlife photography, it is more male dominated than women, because the number of men in this industry is obviously higher because of the societal, you know, perception that women can't do outdoor jobs. But that said, I really don't know if you know, being environmentally conscious comes more to women. Maybe that the fact that, you know, we are also we play an active role in running a house, so maybe that is the reason we tend to be more conscious about the choices that we make. I haven't faced much discrimination at all. In fact, I haven't faced any. But when it comes, like when we go, when I've been to a couple of sanctuaries, so I used to have a very big lens, and that time I was relatively shorter than what I am now. So I have heard people tell that, you know, the lens is as big as you are, and you can you carry that lens, or do you really, you know, if you lift it, will you fall down, and can you take pictures with it? And these are questions that come. I don't really take it to heart. I feel that we can definitely juggle both. You can have a personal life and a professional life as well, because wildlife photography and filmmaking is just like any other profession. Just like a 9-to-5 job requires commitment, so does this. It is very important, because when you look at some of the achievements that women have had in different fields, it shows you the power that women can you know, achieve, and maybe the way in which we can handle ourselves and work hard and achieve our goals. So a lot of girls can get inspired by looking up to female role models, because a lot of times people, you know, drill these into girls' minds that as a girl you are required to do XXXX, you can't do Z, or you can't do something else because you are a girl. It's not accepted by society. Whereas when you look up to someone who has broken those glass ceilings and those barriers, then definitely you also, you know, get inspired to achieve similar things. Don't let your gender ever come in the way of achieving your dreams. You are as much as an equal to a man, and you can achieve the same amount that he can do. So you don't have to let your gender come in the way at all. Secondly, for all girls out there who want to be wildlife photographers, first of all, learn the craft. So when you learn the craft well, you can be as creative as possible on the field. And thirdly is that be safe when you are outdoors, because right now these times are not very safe nowadays for women. So at least when you're outdoors, be cautious and be aware.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any videos by us.